we are going to discuss about null object design pattern theory principles, real life examples and real time examples. In the upcoming video, we will try to discuss about null object design pattern practical implementation using Java. So what is null object design pattern? So traditionally, which means if you are a programmer, you would know that you would use null check for everything. For example, if you are writing a program for adding two numbers for A plus B. So what you do is you would first check whether A is not equal to null and then B is not equal to null. So here we are trying to check whether both values are not equal to null. Then only we will proceed to add these two numbers. So here A not equal to null and B not equal to null are null checks. So that is a traditional method. Traditional method, null check for every value which has some limitations and explore for. If you have failed to put the null check, then that would cause some exceptions. For example, A equal to null, so B equal to some 5. So null plus 5 will throw null pointer exception. So if you want some default behavior for objects which has null for nothing, so if you want some default behavior, then we could use null object design pattern for achieving this same. So we will try to discuss an example so where we could explain the null object design pattern in a detailed manner. So please stay tuned to this video. And then next point is null object class is a default implementation. Default implementation means whenever your program requires some default implementation for nothing and null values, then you could use null object design pattern. So last point is it would be very useful if you want some special flow for something which has nothing and null value. So we can explain that point using some real life example. So for example, these are the people from whom you get the call every day. For example, A, B, C, D and E. These are the people who always call you, and the call between you and them are very important. So you are considering them as important persons in your life. And then F, G, H, I. These are the spammers. So they will try to call and they will try to tell that you have won 50,000 rupees. So please provide your bank details. So we will credit you some amount. So for those people, you will treat them as spammers. You need to reply them only one default message, which means I am not interested. So here F, G, H are null, which means nothing. They are nothing to you. So you need to just reply them with just one message, which is I am not interested. So here, this we can consider this here, and A, B, C, D are important persons for you. So you will try to call, if these people call you, then you will try to talk with them in detailed manner and you will try to discuss many things. If F, G, H, I people call you, then you could reply only one thing, which means I am not interested. So here I am not interested is the default message, which could be handled using null object design pattern. So we will try to cover this example practically, which means we will try to implement this using Java in the next video. So please stay tuned to this series.